I'm not going to count up the years for you. I think you can see what the years have done to me. It is a very, very great honor for me to be recognized by this great organization that I've been privileged to be a member of since 1947. That's 61 years ago. Robert gave me a list of the past chairs a couple of days ago, and I'd like to reminisce with a few of these gentlemen. First off, the first four chairs were really the pioneers of industrial and economic development in this country. Finley French, Frank Cassell, Frank Shaw, and Clifford Gildersleeve. I was privileged to know each one of these gentlemen, and I admired them very much. The next group that I looked, that I discovered, were my contemporaries and my friends. First is Harry Clark of Mississippi. Harry probably didn't invent the industrial revenue bond, but he sure utilized it in building Mississippi. And Mel Peach of Boston, who was recognized by all the leaders of the New England states as one of the great industrial development leaders. And Paul Miller of Atlanta. What you see here today in this great city, a lot of it goes back to Paul Miller. And Tom Finney of Dallas. Everett Tucker of Little Rock. Bill Shelton of Fort Worth. I understand that Bill is at this conference today, this year. And then Bill Hackett of Louisiana. Of course, these and many others came out of the industrial development era when the emphasis was on manufacturing. We used to like to make speeches about what 100 manufacturing employees would do for our community. I think we did that to justify our position, I guess. And of course, we all had friendly people and tree-lined streets. But now economic development has widened. With economic development, we are widened, and our scope is much broader. And we have included urban development as a vital part of our purpose. In looking back over the years, the most constant was change, and there will be more to come. We are within days of the end of the longest presidential campaign in the history of the country. And there have been some interesting turns. In recent days, we have gone from hockey moms to Joe Sixpack, and now Joe the Plumber. Nonetheless, we will have a new president with more change to come, regardless of who is elected. And hopefully that change will include economic recovery that we all must have. One thing will not change, however, and that is your role and the role of your organization in the economic development of your city, your state, and your region. And of course, that applies to our international friends that are now part of this effort. You are the planners and the implementers essential to the future of this great nation. Again, thank you very much for this honor. But remember, ladies and gentlemen, the ball is in your court. Thank you.